But Mr. N.K. Singh, if I could bring you in, because at one level, you can't think of two people more dissimilar than then Finance Minister Manmohan Singh and current Prime Minister Narendra Modi. But Narendra Modi seems to have a very clear vision of the reforms that he wants to bring to India, whether they include, whether it's the banking sector, whether it's the farm sector. And these are reforms he's determined to get through. Yet we see that many of the arguments against reforms haven't changed since 1991. How then does India, which is in a sense always has a lumbering pace, had a blistering pace suddenly in 1991, bring that back today in 2021?
So I think that, I'd make two or three very brief comments. First and foremost, that the 1991, which continued till, which began, of course, a little earlier than 1991, because from 89 onwards, it looked very unsustainable. And the Chandrasekhar government did take some important decisive steps, including the famous mortgage of gold and some other structural and fiscal changes to hold on till 1991, which unleashed that broad set of economic reforms. But if one were to really look back, and I agree that the implementation of many of those have been very, very tardy. One obvious example is that the GST, which was agreed in Article 4 consultations as early as 1992, really waited till 2017 to happen. So that's one example on tardy implementation. But to take your question, what are the lessons which we can draw from the 1991? One important lesson is that never allow a crisis to give you the opportunity which the crisis gives you. Don't waste that opportunity. The 1991 set of circumstances gave an enormous opportunity, which we did a lot to grasp that opportunity, but we failed to fully utilize the public mood, the general sentiment that we needed a tectonic shift from the kind of system which we were running earlier. So that's a lesson which the current leadership has grasped. The ongoing global pandemic, and I agree that this is not India specific, that this is global pandemic. The current leadership believes that the more difficult items of economic reforms, which were left untouched in 1991, particularly on factors of production, on agriculture, on labor, on reforms of the financial and capital market, on much deeper privatization than was at all possible or feasible at that time, including the issue of the ownership of banks, which was, after the nationalization of banks, considered something which was really untouchable. So the big lesson is, do not waste the opportunity of a crisis. And that's the big lesson which the current leadership has learned. And therefore, some of the most difficult items of economic reforms have been undertaken in the last few years. Now, I agree that there would be hundreds of items which are ready to be reformed, but clearly the priorities have been well picked. What are these priorities? One, a mindset change, but a much deeper privatization of all public sectors in general, excepting a few in the strategic areas, on revisiting the issue of the ownership of banks. This is an important mindset change, which of course, given the political circumstances at that time, was not possible in 1991. And the word disinvestment was also an anathema. Mm-hmm. We began with the famous word bundling of shares and so on. So that's one important change. The entire reforms of the agricultural sector, which was left, is an important area of change, and that goes far beyond the farm laws. In fact, the farm laws, if you say currently, is a matter for controversy, but the fact remains that successive governments put forward a similar change in the Agricultural Produce Marketing Act. And this is not the end of the story. It required much deeper changes in terms of crop diversification, moving to less water-intensive modes of crop, moving
Absolutely.
Away from and so on. And advertising on the exports and on, for instance, difficult areas like elusive one on power. So these priorities are reasonably well laid out. And I think that the leadership come to one conclusion. We will seek a consensus, but if consensus eludes us, we'll not wait indefinitely for states to arrive there, but then act with panache, which is necessary to implement these reforms.